Hello, welcome to my Facebook Live. This is the start of a new program titled Storytime. So Storytime is when I've just written a new blog post and I'd like to share it with you by reading it. So some of you may have already seen this article. You may or may not have had a chance to read it. If you don't have a chance to read it, you can just watch it, listen to it. The idea here is for me to be able to share with you what it is that I've been up to as a career coach. I've been doing this for about a year now. And really what I am here to do is help you. If you happen to be somebody who is like me, who is stuck in the wrong line of work or stressed out, experiencing burnout, and you're not really quite sure what to do, you might feel trapped, this is for you. And if that's not you, well, maybe there's something that you can still glean from this that'll be helpful. So, without further ado, I want to kick this off. So this is a blog post I wrote titled, Work Isn't Supposed to Suck, It's Supposed to Be Fun. It's been about a year since I suffered a crippling work injury that led to a medical leave of absence before I made the decision to quit my job, leave tech sales, move to San Diego, and start a business as a career coach. I'm happy to say that everything has changed for the better over the course of the past year. More importantly, I'm pain-free for the first time since my injury, which means I can finally work a full day again, and I no longer have to worry about my ability to maintain a job that requires a significant amount of time using a computer. I suffered what is called a repetitive stress injury, or RSI, which resulted in intense pain and fatigue in both of my forearms, kind of like carpal tunnel, but not really. I came into work on a Monday after having a really incredible weekend at a music festival in Mendocino, only to discover that after 30 minutes of sending emails and entering details into Salesforce, that I couldn't type or mouse without this burning pain shooting up both forearms. It was not pleasant. Now, let's fast forward to the end of the quarter. In sales, we work on quarterly cycles, and that's kind of how we track time and progress. Well, by the end of the quarter, it was not pretty. I was struggling just to keep my head above water each day. Somehow, I managed to get through each day, hobbled as I was. Fortunately, I had a prescription for anti-anxiety meds that seemed to magically ease the pain for long enough that I was able to do just enough to show that I was at least trying to keep my job. It wasn't until the start of the following quarter that I realized that something was seriously wrong. 3 months had passed, and I was just as handicapped as I was when I got the injury, and taking Xanax each day at work just to get by was not a sound long-term strategy. A change needed to be made. And not the kind of change that requires an updated resume and a round of interviews. I mean like a major life change needed to be made. Tech sales was destroying me. The stress, the pressure, the physical demands of the role, where you're expected to be in the office by 7 a.m. each day, and breaks are non-existent over the course of the day. Now, the cracks had been there all along. I'd flirted with disability previously in my last tech company, but I was able to throw a Band-Aid on it, armbands for a tennis elbow, and just power through it. That's just kind of how I operated at the time. But this wasn't even the worst of it. Before any of the physical ailments began to manifest, I was dealing with a much more existential dilemma. No longer could I ignore the questions like, what am I doing with my life? Is this really worth it? I knew what the answer was, yet I felt completely trapped. What choice did I have? I was well paid and established in a career that I worked incredibly hard to advance in. What was I going to do? Start over again? That just seemed like an awful lot to throw away just because I didn't like my job very much. So after meeting with my doctor, we decided the best thing for me would be to take a medical leave of absence in the hopes that some rest and relaxation might help restore my arms to health so I could get back to work once and for all. After a couple weeks off, I noticed slight improvements, but nothing that told me that I'd be anywhere near 100% by the end of the 4-week break. It was at this point that I got serious about crafting a plan to right the sinking ship that had become my life at the time. I knew a few things for sure. Tech sales would continue to destroy me. And any other corporate job that required me to work at a computer all day, doing work that wasn't aligned with my values or interests. So I went back to the drawing board to consider other alternatives. That's when I remembered this idea that I had tucked away collecting dust in the corner of my mind, which was to work as a life coach. So I picked it up, I dusted it off, and began exploring it seriously for the first time. Pretty soon, it started to make sense. It would be a job where I could spend much more time on the phone or video conference than on a computer. It allowed me to work at my own pace, on my own schedule, at a level of intensity that felt appropriate. Most importantly, however, was that it would give me a chance of doing the work that felt meaningful and personally satisfying. I've been geeking out on psychology and personal development since I was a teenager, and coaching was the perfect way for me to put all my knowledge, training, and practice to use. So that was it. After I'd done enough soul searching to understand that if there's one thing I'm passionate about, it's helping people overcome obstacles that had dogged me for so much of my life. I loved working one-on-one with people in sales, but my heart was just never in it. Now I could leverage all the skills and experience I gained over the years in combination with my psychology and neuroscience degree in a way that would be personally satisfying. The plan was hatched and the wheels were set in motion as soon as my roommate told me he was moving out. With the cost of living continuing to escalate in San Francisco, I knew that I couldn't stay, it just wasn't feasible, and that I was going to need a dramatic change in lifestyle in order to fully recover from this injury that was largely stress-induced. Cue San Diego. It had a really nice ring to it. I've been fantasizing for years about starting a new life spent on the sun-soaked beaches of this laid-back SoCal city. I'd only visited once previously on a short work trip 8 years ago, but it was long enough for me to fit in my first surf lesson and get a real sense for just how relaxed life could be down here. Thanksgiving rolled around, and with my family in town, I let them in on my not-so-little secret. I was about to quit my job and leave everything behind in order to start the next chapter of my life as an entrepreneur, aspiring life coach, and resident of San Diego. A couple of weeks later, I loaded up a U-Haul truck and drove 10 hours straight down Route 5 to my new apartment in downtown San Diego. For the past year, I've been hard at work at building my business, settling into life in this new environment, all the while continuing to receive regular acupuncture treatments for my arms. I'm happy to say that I had my last round of acupuncture for my arms last month. Now it's just a little bit of work for eye strain. And that through it all, I've been able to establish a thriving business as a career coach, helping people who have found themselves in their own dire straits. I share this story for many reasons. I hope for it to be a cautionary tale for anyone who, like me, may be noticing and ignoring the warning signs of what could ultimately be a precursor to something much worse. I also hope that it serves as an inspiration to anyone who may also be feeling like they're not in alignment with the right kind of work and they're fed up with it. Not everyone is going to have the same experience as I had working in sales or in the corporate world. I know many people who enjoy it and hope to continue in sales or the corporate world for many years. But some will. There are so many different types of personalities that may or may not jive with a particular profession. This is inevitable. The question is, if you're the person who recognizes that you're not in the right line of work, what are you going to do? Do you know that change is possible? Are you aware that the right line of work exists for everyone if they can just figure out what it is and how to make it happen? If any of my story resonates with you, then I'd love to hear about it. My mission in life is to be the person that people can turn to in their darkest moments of grief and desperation. I intend to be a beacon of hope for people who feel beaten down by life as I have. And it gives me such great joy and satisfaction to know that I'm able to make a difference in somebody else's life. As far as careers are concerned, all it takes is an adjustment, an opportunity to take a step back, look at the big picture of a person's life to reassess what's most important to someone in order to course correct. Just like for an airline pilot, if I'm able to influence even just 1 degree change in a client's trajectory, then I know that I've also just influenced that person's destination to a degree that you can't even measure. The good life is very much possible. It isn't easy. Recovering from my injury and building this business has by far been the most challenging period of my life. But it's also been so worth it. This has also been the most transformative period of my life, leading to so much personal growth and professional satisfaction. All you have to do is to commit to making it a reality. To take a chance on yourself and doggedly pursue your hopes and dreams with no consideration for what others might think and say. That's it. And hopefully you'll do it the smart way and hire a coach to be in your corner as you navigate the unfamiliar terrain of your new life. I invite you to email me if you feel inspired to have a conversation about your own hopes and dreams. I'd like to hear about what obstacles and roadblocks may be preventing you from creating the life you know that you deserve. I really don't care if you decide to work with me or not. What I do care about is that you give it serious consideration. Work is not worth suffering over. It's supposed to be fun. All right, so that's it. That's my latest blog post. I'm looking to put one of these out each week as a way to give people insight into this coaching world that I've been putting together, as well as provide some advice and some ideas around how to find professional satisfaction. I speak with people every day that feel stuck in the wrong line of work. They're miserable. They're unhappy. They're stressed out. Sunday night rolls around and they're just filled with dread. And that's just a shame, because at least 8 hours of every single day are spent at work. And if you're not happy with work, then, well, you're not going to be happy with life. And that's just not okay, or it shouldn't be okay if you're putting up with that. So that's what this is all about. Hope you enjoyed this video. I'll be posting on this topic for the next week, this idea of burnout and really the perils of stress at work, because it is part of our culture. You know, no pain, no gain. Stress seems to be an acceptable state of being in our world, and it's just not, because it's not good for you. It's unhealthy on so many levels. My experience was an extreme example, right? Chances are you're not going to be the kind of person who's going to feel crippled and have to take a medical leave of absence, but maybe you are. This isn't that uncommon. When I went to the medical clinic to get my treatment, it was filled with people that had the same condition, that came in there with arms that couldn't type or mouse. It's really just kind of ridiculous, but it is becoming a bit of an epidemic and something that needs to be addressed. And the way that the corporate world operates right now, especially if you're working for a publicly traded company where, you know, there's a lot of influence and interest in just growth, 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 more revenue, more work, more deadlines, you know, more stress, what that means is that you're going to get your ass kicked sooner or later. And you got to make sure that you're, you know, taking care of yourself. So self-care is something that I talk to all of my clients about, whether it's meditation, exercise, yoga, diets, proper sleep. I mean, this is really key, but that's just kind of the stuff to do on the periphery of your life. If the core of your life is kind of this situation where it's just nonstop stress, well, that might mean that it's time to take a step back and just reevaluate your current set of circumstances, because anything is possible for yourself, right? So when I quit my job in sales a year ago, I had to start over at that point, but doesn't have to take that long to create that next thing. And if you do, and you do it successfully, and you work with a coach in order to make that transition a smooth and an easy one, well, you've got the rest of your life to enjoy it. And that's what this is all about. You know, if you're in a type of work that you don't like it, you're stressed out, you're unhappy, well, can you really see yourself doing that until the age of 65 or longer? I mean, is that really a life that you want for yourself? Or could you imagine yourself in a different situation where Monday morning rolls around, you're excited to get out of bed, you can't wait to start working because you like what you do, you know, and that's completely possible. Everybody has it within themselves to find work that really fires them up. Everybody has passions, you know, they just don't know, right? So that's my job. And that's what's really fun about being a coach is that I get to be the one to help uncover what these passions are that have been dormant for so many years, right? And they're always there. It's just a matter of sifting through somebody's life story, their experiences, their interests, their values, really just spending time to get to know who they are and who they've always been. So when you see these clues that have been there since day one, it starts to paint a pretty clear picture. So I'm 100% certain that if you were to work with myself or somebody, you know, along the same lines and did this type of work, you would absolutely uncover your thing, which then gives you the opportunity to build your life around that thing, which could mean a new job in a different industry, could mean starting your own business, really could mean anything. It's really amazing to see what happens when somebody gets clear in their head about what it is that they want. You know, clients of mine started out confused and then gained such clarity by the end of a 3-month program that the opportunities start finding them. You know, you can call it law of attraction. You can talk about it in terms of psychology. It's the reticular activation system that you start seeing in the world those things that you have in your mind. So the opportunities start to present themselves, and that's really the magic of this work. So anyways, I don't want to ramble for too long here. That's my spiel. If this is interesting to you, if you'd like to learn more information, check out my website, adammitchellhardt.com. You can always email me, adam@adammitchellhardt.com, or just send me a message on Facebook. Be happy to chat, you know. But if you're good, we'll just keep on checking out my content if it's interesting to you. Hope you're having a good day, and we'll do this another time. That's story time. Bye.